This portion of New Day Northwest is sponsored by Virginia Mason.
Welcome back. According to the National Institutes of Health, 1 in 15 Americans suffer from an autoimmune disease. In the Pacific Northwest, there is a greater prevalence of MS, irritable bowel disease, and type 1 diabetes, all autoimmune related. Dr. Kate Speake and Cassidy Benosik from Benaroya Research Institute at Virginia Mason are part of a new initiative called the Sound Life Project to better understand the immune system in health and disease. Welcome. First of all, why do we have a prevalence? Open it up to either of you.
That's a great question, and honestly, the answer is still unknown. It's a very active area of research. There's a whole lot of guesses as to why things are a little worse here in the Northwest, but honestly, that's part of why we need to keep doing our work.
Right, and we've known that there's a prevalence for kind of a while now.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
So it's not like a little blip. It's been here.
No, many autoimmune diseases have been increasing in prevalence for decades, in fact. And so that's something that BRI is highly focused on trying to understand.
Well, let's talk about what your work focuses on, how you go about this.
Yeah, so BRI in general, I think Cassidy might want to open up on that.
Yeah, so Benaroya Research Institute at Virginia Mason, or BRI, is one of the few research institutes in the world dedicated to finding causes and cures of immune system diseases. As you mentioned, autoimmune diseases like multiple sclerosis and Crohn's disease, type 1 diabetes, lupus, and also immune-mediated diseases such as allergies and asthma. And our mission is to really find ways to prevent and just really find cures.
Yeah, that's what you guys do. Those are some of the primary diseases. There are others that affect people. I'm thinking of POTS and some other things like that that affect people as well. But I feel like we all know somebody who's got an autoimmune disease if we don't ourselves, and it's so common. What is the Sound Life Project?
Yeah, the Sound Life Project is a new initiative that's done in partnership between BRI and the Allen Institute for Immunology. And we're looking to understand the healthy immune system.
Yeah, and in order to do that, we're enrolling participants into our study in two groups, ages 25 to 35 and 55 to 65.
Okay, now we
are. Yes, and so they'll be in the study for around 2 years, and in that 2 years, they'll be coming in for 10 study visits and donating some blood and answering questions such as lifestyle questions, health questions, family history, things like that. We've also developed a phone app that people are able to download onto their phones, and they can answer brief surveys that way. And then this also allows us to take a look at location and things, environmental factors such as air quality and pollen counts.
So who would qualify for the study?
So we really are wanting to enroll people that are considered very healthy, maybe not on a lot of medications. You know, this is for this particular study. We have a lot of studies going on at Benaroya Research Institute.
Right.
So if they aren't eligible for this one, they can definitely probably fit into something else too.
So the interesting thing about this is that if you're healthy, you probably haven't thought about being part of a study. And so I imagine it takes a little bit of effort to understand why it's important and motivate people to want to do it. Because if you're healthy, you're not even really thinking along these lines. But it can be super important to get people to participate. Can you explain the significance?
Yeah, I think that's totally right. The majority of our studies we couldn't do without healthy participants, right? Because if we can't understand what's going on in the context of health and the many differences between us in the context of health, it would be very difficult to understand what's important and what changes when people get these diseases. And as you mentioned, you know, so many of us either have these diseases, 1 in 15 Americans have these diseases, which basically means that every one of us knows someone in our lives.
So if you're healthy and you know someone, you might do it on their behalf.
Yeah.
If I could give some encouragement for people to participate, how would someone get in touch with you to take part?
Yeah, so taking a peek at our website, there's lots of information on there. They can sign up right there on the website, and then we will give people further information and just have that conversation with them.
This sort of research, sometimes when it starts, we don't know where it's going to end up, but can you give me some examples of breakthroughs or discoveries or ways in which we're dealing with autoimmune diseases that have come out of similar studies and why it's so urgent?
Yeah, I mean, one example is work that was done at BRI and many other sites in these last couple of years, but we have a program called Type 1 Diabetes Trial Net, an international clinical trial network. And within the last year, we published a study that showed that there's a drug that can actually delay diabetes onset. And that's really meaningful for families, mm-hmm. right? A couple of years delay would mean a couple of years without insulin and having to monitor right. their blood sugars. And that's really meaningful for people who have to manage these diseases. Obviously, we'd ultimately like to move that further, but that's work that was done at BRI with yeah. in collaboration with other sites, and work like the Cell Life Project could help us make similar breakthroughs.
That's a great, great point. And maybe if people don't understand the difficulties that people with autoimmune diseases face, perhaps you could fill us in why this is so important. We hear about yeah. cancer, we hear about other things, but
right.
you know, this is a major, this has major impact on people.
Definitely, it can limit their day-to-day activities. People with multiple sclerosis, IBD, which is Crohn's, ulcerative colitis, type 1 diabetes. Imagine a teenager or a child having to
Absolutely.
Be in a classroom and have some of the complications and challenges that come with the diseases, as well as allergies and
yeah,
food allergies.
Which I feel like everybody has these days. Mm-hmm. Is one autoimmune disease make you more likely to suffer another?
It does. It does increase your risk of having more than one. Yes.
So if you have allergies, for example, might you be more vulnerable to another autoimmune problem?
Allergies and asthma in particular go together, mm-hmm. right? There are other autoimmune diseases that kind of run in families together. So, for example, type 1 diabetes and celiac disease are strongly linked right. together. Understanding how we can prevent one of those might then ultimately lead to the prevention of multiple autoimmune diseases in a given person. And you know, we think that would be really powerful.
Yeah. Well, there's some hopeful stuff out there, and this is part of the hope that we can participate and make a difference and make life better for other people. Thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. To find out how you can participate in the Sound Life Project or any of the clinical trials at Benaroya Research Institute at Virginia Mason, please visit benaroyaresearch.org. We'll have that on our website as well to make it really easy. I'll put it up on my social media too today. When Wellness Wednesday returns, how parents, grandparents, and others can better navigate the holidays for kids after a divorce in the family. That's next.